My name is Mahek Mehta, and I am a member of Dr. Robert Johnston's lab in Baltimore, Maryland at Johns Hopkins University. So we're trying to figure out how the color perception works inside a fly's retina. So we study fruit flies, we dissect their retinas, and we image them using special types of technology and microscopy. And the whole point of that is to sort of decide how the randomness works within the retina to decide how Drosophilas are able to see and how their vision is determined. When I was younger, around middle school, my sister became dehydrated at a very young age after a trip to my home country of India. The hospital that we were in, for some reason, just her doctor and just the environment really inspired me to get involved with medicine. My sister and I, we used to pretend that I was a doctor and she had various crazy ailments. That's just how I ended up really loving medicine, and that translates to my love for science, because it's not just about doctor-patient interaction, it's also about understanding the basics behind science. There were several hurdles that I had to get over in order to get to this point, but I knew that I wasn't going to take no for an answer from that standpoint. I knew that I didn't want to waste my time, especially this being my last year of high school. I wanted to do something that could truly prepare me for my college experience. So I was wondering if, since this is a null genotype, should I dissect them before or after I do the normal variants?
So do the normal variants.
And it's really cool for me to have the opportunity to be able to speak with undergraduates who were in my position only a few years ago, and actually get their advice on the college process and how my work here translates into what I'll do during my undergraduate years. It's also really cool to see the graduate students in action, because despite the fact that there's a significant gap age-wise, they're so incredibly helpful in terms of giving advice and in terms of helping me pave my path and really get my own research going. I love the applicability of science and the fact that it really does have an impact on other people's lives. It's not just something that I do for me, but it's something that translates into other people's day-to-day lives as well. My number one piece of advice is to not take no for an answer. You will, at a young age, because of a lack of experience, a lot of people are reluctant to give you an opportunity. And you have to understand that if you keep taking no for an answer, you'll never get the experience that you need to get farther. And there will come a time when someone does give you a shot, and you have to wait for that and you have to work for that. And so the best advice that I can give to anyone my age or younger is to simply not take no for an answer and just send out as many emails as you need to everybody and everybody on, to anybody and everybody on any given scientific website, for any university, for any institution, and just get your foot in the door, because I promise you it will pay off in the end.